Now, we are known to be a groundbreaking show, but today we are taking that to a whole new level by answering the question, the really important question, can you cook a lasagna in the dishwasher? Yesterday, Jess, the lovely Jess, gave it a bash, and although she carefully prepared it, it's fair to say it really didn't turn out that well after being cooked in the dishwasher.
It smelled like vomit that had been eaten and then vomited up again.
And there was so much wort in it.
It was horrible.
The water was pouring out of it. But in true Jess style, she is no quitter and today has vowed to give it another go under very strict conditions. So lovely Jess got up nice and early this morning to prepare another lasagna. Let's take a look.
Great. Okay, so I've got two. But then should I put a bit more around here, I think?
Sure.
Let's really go to town on the alfoil.
Yeah, cool.
It's alfoil. Thank you, Grant. Here by Grant. Oh, there's a gap. Oh, no. Look, it's broken. You can't have anything here.
Yeah. This? Sorry, mate.
Now we actually have the EP, Rob McKnight, involved in this very important process. Come on, if we're putting a lasagna in the dishwasher, at least we can make it look like a cat. After much debate and discussion, we decided to put the lasagna upside down on the top shelf. Please don't drop out. There we go. So far, so good. Close it up. And it's got to go on the toughest cycle. Power, heavy duty. See you soon in a couple of hours, lasagna.
And joining us now with all the crucial developments on this breaking international story is Jess. You're joining us from the Network 10 kitchen. Jess, bring us up to date on any developments.
Well, Tash, as you could see there, it was highly scientific this morning what we were doing. It took many of us to seal it. I can hear the lasagna cooking beautifully. We put a special sign here. No one can open that because that was a mistake that I made yesterday, opening it and I stuffed up the heating cycle. But you know what? I don't want to just stop at a lasagna. I thought, you see, this might tempt your taste buds, Ita. I'd cook salmon also in the dishwasher because we have a second one here.
Don't do anything on my behalf, Jessica. The lasagna's fine.
Oh, no. Ita, this is especially for you because I know you are a woman of discerning taste. So some lemon, little bit of dill. And I'm going to wrap that as well.
I don't know what I did, why God's punishing me this way.
Oh, no. Don't be like that. Do you know, just before I prepared all of this, I spoke to my sister, who is in fact a chef, and I said, do you have any tips for me cooking in a dishwasher?
Yeah,
and
don't.
That was it. Exactly, that's what she said. She said, no, I have no tips at all. OK, now veggies, OK, because it's so important we have veggies.
Not vegetables, Jess.
Yeah, we've got to. You know, I tell my daughters all the time they've got to eat their veggies,
Tash. This is too much.
And don't you think this would be quite an exciting way to get the kids involved with cooking each afternoon? Let's put it in the dishwasher. Let's see what happens. OK. So that is all snugly prepared. This is going in onto the top shelf. I won't tip this one upside down though. Okay. Oh. So salmon, veggies, lasagna. What more could you possibly want for lunch? You'll be listening.
Oh, I think I'll just have a McDonald's.
Oh, I know. Yeah. Just wait. There we go. It's on.
Oh, Jess.
Pretty impressive.
You've got two dishwashers there.
She does not give up.
No,
she says,
why? I don't.
Why not?
The problem is that when it's all done, no one's going to have anything to eat it off because there won't be any bloody dishes.
Oh, good point. Now, apparently, we need to do another reminder for this clock. Do you want to read the clock, Joe?
This is great. This is better than the countdown to Australian Idol. In just 1 minute. What is it? 1 hour, 20 minutes and 31 seconds. I'm about to be physically ill.
I'm a celebrity. Get me out of here.